Welcome to the FDA catch-up on XReal Air 2 Pro versus Viture XR Pro glasses. In May 2024, the Viture XR Pro glasses were released in what now seems a direct competitor of the XReal Air 2 Pro glasses. If you are thinking about getting either of them, I will show you a few differences I've found so far. Prescription inserts. The Viture XR Pro glasses come with two dials to adjust moderate nearsightedness up to a power of -5. This is really a game changer for those who are short-sighted, as it makes the glasses less bulky and more enjoyable, as you don't really have to clean the inserts or see the blurry corners just where the inserts end. Glasses temples. The XReal Air 2 Pro glasses allow you to adjust the temples vertically. Interestingly, the Viture XR Pros, despite not being adjustable, provide a comfortable fit. Possibly they have found a design that works without having to adjust up or down the lenses. Also, not having movable parts give the impression of the XR Pros being sturdy when comparing against the XReal Air 2 Pros. Electrochromic film. This is a win for the XReal Air 2 Pro glasses, as it offers more options for those who require three levels of darkness: super dark, dark, and clear. The Viture XR Pro glasses just offer two levels: super dark and clear. Wear sensor. This could be a contributor to the higher temperature of the Viture XR Pro. More on that later on this video, but the XReal Air 2 Pro comes with a proximity sensor that makes the glasses go to sleep mode when not being used. This not only saves battery on the device connected to the glasses, but also reduces the heat and ensures that the glasses are switched on only when in use. Unlike the adjustment of the temples, I think this is a feature that I'm missing while using the XR Pro glasses. Cable material. The braided cable that comes with the XReal Air 2 Pro seems to imply that it would be more durable than the non-braided one that comes with the XR Pro, but only time will tell. Cable connector. The XReal Air 2 Pro glasses come with a male-to-female USB-C cable that, although it doesn't have the flat shape of a USB-C cable, it could be replaced with any compatible USB-C cable that you find in your house. This is useful in case of emergency, or if you require a longer cable, you can just simply replace it. However, the Viture XR Pro comes with a cable which is USB-C male on one end, but it is a custom magnetic connector on the other end. The connector is strong and provides a secure lock. I really like it, but it brings the question as to how do we buy a replacement if we ever need one? Would other companies sell this kind of cable? And also, is this becoming a classic case of that Apple cable that the European Union was trying to get rid of? Cover. The Viture XR Pro doesn't come with the glasses cover, but it's useful when you are using the glasses under very bright light conditions, and it also serves as a protector of the lenses. The quality of the covers that come with the XReal Air 2 Pro to me seem slightly better than the one of the Viture XR Pro. Operating temperature. After 20 minutes of gaming and watching 3D videos, both glasses become warm, but nothing particularly unpleasant. The Viture XR Pros tend to be slightly warmer, but not significantly. Overall, the Viture XR Pro are to me a better choice in terms of hardware and software when compared to the XReal Air 2 Pro. It is a snug fit and the software is much better with fewer bugs. However, to enjoy all the features, you might need to buy separately the different accessories. In my case, the software to watch 3D movies and the fact that the prescription inserts are not required is a good enough reason to get these. This is all for now. Hope you find some of this information useful. See you later.